Click It or Ticket campaign kicks off today. It's the state's yearly push to keep drivers buckled up and safe during the busy travel season. And no one knows that better than the two sisters you are about to meet. Carol Evans Kenderdahl has their story.
Buckling up is second nature for Kelly Abraham.
Always. Don't even think about it.
But that's because she's got a lot of other things on her mind.
You know, every time I get behind the wheel, I do think about getting in a car accident.
An accident like the one in this Elbertville intersection a year and a half ago. Kelly's SUV totaled after a driver turned left right into her path.
How was your day?
Luckily, Kelly was alone and walked away thanks to her seatbelt. But by that time...
There you go. You're set.
Kelly's sons were already well aware of the importance of that simple action.
And I remember the airbags flying in my face.
Do you remember your seatbelt cutting into you?
Yep.
Brady Abrahamson was just 4 years old when his family was in another, more serious crash.
A lady decided it was her day to commit suicide, so she parked her vehicle in the HOV lane and walked back into oncoming traffic.
Kelly's husband swerved their white SUV to miss the woman, hitting her parked car at 70 miles an hour instead.
My two-year-old was in a five-point restraint, and my four-year-old was in a booster, and the only injury that either of them received was my four-year-old bit his tongue.
And it was a frontal head-on impact, which, unbelted, is virtually unsurvivable.
Trooper Carla Beer says that as a trained crash reconstructionist and Kelly's sister.
It's a miracle that they're all here today.
And it's not her sister's first miracle.
I think it was, I flew out that window 30 feet, they said.
Right front.
21 years ago, Kelly was in the passenger seat, unbuckled, when a classmate T-boned a pickup that failed to yield the intersection.
That feeling of, okay, there's really nothing we can do except pray.
I was always very thankful for that farmer who didn't cut his hay, because they said that was probably one of the reasons I did not have any spinal injuries.
The crash is a reason why Carla pursued her specialty, and it's why Kelly hasn't forgotten to buckle up since.
And it changed the entire course of my life.
Now, Kelly wasn't responsible for any of those three crashes she survived. She says she sometimes gets asked if she feels lucky or unlucky. She told me she feels blessed because she survived and she is able to help others by sharing her story. And I think anyone would agree after seeing that, guys.
Wow, absolutely. What a story. Yeah. And especially when you think of them hitting 70 miles per hour, those little babies in the car, and he just bit his tongue.
Just bit his tongue.
Pretty powerful. Thank you, Kent.